Sam, joined in the booth by Mike Stevenson and Nick Connick. We're here to bring you another great game of Bethel Park football. Tonight is homecoming weekend at Bethel Park, and they're facing Cannon Mack. Now, guys, it should be an interesting game tonight. But one way or the other, Cannon Mack is 0-3 so far this season, and they lost all 10 games they played last year. And Bethel Park just came off a big loss, 35-7 against Woodland Hill. Now, you think on paper it looks like this game could go either way. But if you think about it, it's pretty even. It's almost like an even game. Cannon Mack has had the easiest schedule so far. Like Upper St. Clair, Penn Hills, and Central Catholic in the first three games. And I don't know about you guys, but what do you think is going to go down?
I'm saying 21-17 Bethel Park.
All I'm gonna have to go with the hook part. 35. Well, that's it, folks. Stay tuned. The game's coming up right next. We'll be here the whole game permanent for you on BBTV. Don't go away.
Six for the Big Macs. third down in the game for Kevin Hyde.
Under center, Kevin Mack. Motion man and track back. And he has stopped after about a 1 yard gain.
That was a carry.
That
was big.
That was a big stop. That's what they needed. As it draws fourth and about five. Closer to fourth and four, I'm sorry. On a 34 yard line.
They'll send Avery Gill back in to receive the punt.
Jacob Nibble already has 200 for the season for the Hawks.
19.
They'll come into the game against Corbin. Oh, almost blocked. And Dibble decides to receive it. And he is stopped on number 83.
Dibble comes down to number 83.
Alex Campbell. Factor in Cannon Mag's team this year.
So obviously, he's got the park territory up to 30 yard line. First down, 10.
I don't know about you, but I wouldn't like to
go. I mean, no, it's happening. Avery Dibble ran the wrong way.
And Nathaniel getting his second start as a varsity quarterback tonight, a true freshman. Vinny Emma, Avery Dibble split off to the side. Mascaro and Enoch in the backfield. And the give is to Enoch in the zone around the end. And he has stopped after almost no game.
We're going to be handed off to number 31, Zach Enoch.
Besides the Cannon Mack's O-line, but their D-line seems...
Tackle number 83, Alex Campbell. 1 yard gain will bring up a second down line for the Hawks after a 41-yard line.
Seems as though the ground game is going to... It may or may not play a factor tonight. The Hawks. Trips to the left. And there's a flag on the play thrown on the back side. Let's get the call. Offsides.
Dead ball. Offsides on the defense.
Neutral zone pressure.
They'll bring up a second down and four for the Blackhawks.
44 and winding here in the first quarter. Ball on the 46 yard line, and the give up the middle to John Mascaro. Puts out to the 49 for a third down and
Mascaro
one.
Mascaro on the carry. Back by number 49, Connor Holinski. They bring up a third down one for the Hawks after a 49 yard line.
May have a reason why.
offense is already starting to walk back. So then
holding on Bethel.
Holding on Bethel Park.
That is what killed them against Mount Lebanon. Two plays of over 60 yards called back because of holding penalties.
And one included a big touchdown run.
One was the touchdown, the other one was Indianapolis knocked out of bounds at the two on a fake punt. The coaches, the offensive line coach down the sideline, Adam Fasella, he was not happy about that call at all. And Matheny, he rolls out. He fires at the devil and it is picked off. It is picked off.
He won the team's pass as intended for number 10, and he did it. Intercepted by number 24.
Dibble was started from behind, and I guess one hand came out and caused him to go up in the air, and it was a strong safety. Number 24, Colin Chapinka, was able to get, it was a one-handed grab, by the way.
Coaches did not seem to be happy with the
first pass of the night. The baby definitely isn't happy.
Ball spun at the 25-yard line with Big Max first and 10.
That's Matheny's first varsity interception. And the ball is humbled and he tries it. He picks it up, gets around the end, but his blood still brought down behind the line of scrimmage by Zach Rudd. Another very aggressive player on the Hawks both ways.
Back up number 7, Zachary Rush.
That was very lucky that that loss was
4-yard loss. We're going to have a second down 14.
Had him way in the back, it had him right where the ball is, but he was able to slip down the end a little bit.
He was good for half work, but he was still able to get the sack.
According to Coach Tim Soida, one of the Canamax strengths are the offensive and defensive line, I mean, rightfully so. With Alex Paulina, the sophomore, 6'4", 292 pounds, sophomore.
And you can already see early in this game, not very effective, but you can see that they definitely have some potential.
Timeout. Think about Canamax being the first of the half. I mean, just listen to these. You know, 6'2", 219 pounds. 6'1", 208 pounds. 6'1", 238, 6'4", 293. You know, 6'4", 232. I mean, those are like collegiate size guys, which is why a lot of college coaches are finding their way to Kansas.
Yeah, that size will help any team.
He said he's offensive and defensive line because those guys are one of their strengths, but one of their weaknesses are their inexperience. One of those guys I just mentioned on the line,
scoreboard, George Intel, Mike Lindman, Jerry Mastriani,
thank you, gentlemen. I mean, you've seen that so far. I mean, Bethel Park isn't, you know, out of the question for a bad team. I mean, they've always produced a good football team. And then, as I said earlier before, playing with Central Catholic, Penn Hills, and Everett St. Clair for the first three games. I mean, that's the tough schedule that Coach Soida was talking about.
And this Cannon Mac offense will be very scary in the upcoming years, especially with these offensive linemen becoming seniors.
Gaining experience, I can see
that. Second down 14 for the Big Macs after 21 yard line.
The quarterback, Alec Hutchin, the junior, 5'9", 155. Flag flies in the Canamac backfield.
Kelly on the carry, flag on the play.
I don't think we haven't seen a pass play at all for Canamac.
Not yet, we haven't.
I think they'll be very far from the team.
Killing the motion on the Big Macs.
Thank you.
Punches back is incomplete.
Run out of bounds. So it'll be 4th and 11. It looks like we're going to send a punching back over here.
Yeah, you can see that kind of clearly does not trust their passing offense, but in that situation,
they're bringing number 18, Jacob Martin, to punt for the big match and send number 10, Avery Dibble, back deep for the Blackhawks.
Stats, but also they could lead with more points on the scoreboard.
Bethel Park seems like they're having no trouble driving Skinner Mac off defense back into the zone.
Slowly they're seeming to driving it back into the zone. From the sixth play on this drive. And then he dropped back to pass again. And he decides to keep it for himself. The last thing you want to do as a quarterback is let the defense know that you're scared to throw after throwing an interception. So I think it's good that the things come back.
Offside on Cannon McMillan.
Neutral zone infraction again on Cannon Mack.
This defense, they keep getting pushed back. Maybe they're trying to get a little jump start on the ball and just jump it too early.
Well, we still have the 4
and 4
line
and
go.
6-6,
195-pound
receiver. Time out. I think if I can't act, that's the second time out for the first quarter.
Hey,
time out.
Sponsors in the season's contest, serving with Kingdom Clark Consumer Products, the most trusted and recognized consumer brand.
Well,
your tower packing needs, don't come to Park Tower Clark Office Clinic. Dr. Rosinek and his staff have been providing customer care to the Park Tower and their families for 25 years.
Well,
that was here come the Hawks, first down and goal at there at the 4-yard line.
Yeah. Thank you.
bubble screen too, that Alex Miller. And he gets his 50 edge sail and he breaks the double tackle. Those were big plays that Bethel Park has been practicing all week. And it appears as though their work just paid off. That Minton was able to have the edge sealed by the tight end. But then he was able to get a good ball right into the red basket, and he was able to take it for 21 yards. Bethel Park will take the first time out of the half.
It seemed there was a little confusion whether the sophomore team should have been on the field. Coaches, one saying he should have been on, one saying he should have been off.
They want to pay attention. Our club will be around to see these sellers lunch for $10. Please support that program. The cheerleading group will be selling raffle tickets for big baskets. A lot of school guys will make a club court. The fans will be selling B-Punk birthday apparel. On the school board side of the main club court. And the football boosters are also selling the pickup shirts on the school side of the main club court. Please support all those great programs.
Walk us down him, but he knows it, and he took it upon himself this week to practice. He was taking it every day, very practice, and he was around a little bit after just to pick, because he knows how, you know, a lot of games don't come down to the field goal. You know, football is, you know, like a region close game.
It's good to see a kid with dedication like that, and the ability to.
First down and 10 for the Hawks at the 29-yard line of the Big Macs.
Just talking about Danny, he knew the pressure he was under. Yeah, but then he runs the option and he gets a clear pitch to the leg. Disaster, one on one. And he breaks the tackle space. Touchdown.
The
kick is up
and it is good. The score now reads Bethel Park 14, Canada 0.
The
Start with the ball on the 18-yard line. First and 10.
shotgun in the bubble. Tried running in direction to Kelly.
The fumble. Kelly fell on the ball.
Off his hands. Over there on the second down. About 10.
That's it. That was the second.
9 yard loss over the second down 19 for Big Max.
9.5 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Second and 19 upcoming for Big Max.
Recovered by the Big Macs on their half-yard line.
And there's the rest of our signaling, but is down on the one-yard line. That was another, a second straight close call. That'll put them back.
We're going to third down for Big Macs.
20 yards. Third and 28. I'm coming for the Big Macs at 31. This is the place you do not want to make a mistake if you are Cannon Mac.
I understand they don't trust them passing, but in this situation, you just have to. They don't want to run for a loss, and
right now, they just have to make sure that they can get their punter enough room to work with, to where the punt's not going to get blocked. Bubba Parkson doesn't get back there, but the punter's at his comfortable distance from the long snap. And if he's this close, you never know.
There was a flag on the play, a chop block on the Big Macs. It was declined by Bethel Park.
A flag, a chop block, removed the ball even closer to the flag. I mean, not much.
Actually, I think that was declined, Sam, and they took the yard flag off the miscue off the snap.
He's able to get about a yard on the play, if that. Still not giving their punter much
room. Kelly on the carry, brought down by number 91, Michael Booker, offering up a fourth down.
Nope, another
excellent.
Big
Max.
Excellent.
Back to the scene.
I heard
on
the punt team right now,
Bethel
Park, all you're thinking is let's try to block this one and get at least 2 points out of it.
Martin, the kick for the Big Max.
It looks like they have their all-out block on the line. Got people running in, almost blocked. They got one off quick, and this isn't a very good punt at all. They're letting it roll, trying to get as many yards as they can, and it is down on the 30-yard line.
Well, spotted the 30-yard line of the Big Macs.
Another time, Sam, where Bethel Park's going
to be. We'd like to thank Cleanly Pizza for taking care of the staff in the press box tonight. Thanks, Cleanly Pizza, for your colorful support of the Bethel Park Complex. Cleanly Pizza is delicious.
Remaining here.
still able to get a first down before getting into the end zone here.
Flag, there's a flag on that play, an illegal shift on the Hawks. And Fanny fakes the rollout and he rolls out, fires it to Brunner.
The pass is incomplete. Tipped by number 91, Michael Brucker.
Tipped by
number 17, Jordan Descalci.
Make a big play.
Tipped
by
number 17, Jordan Descalci. Tipped by number 17, Jordan
pass intended for Mike Brucker. Then he's back in the shotgun with Tripp to the left. And he's going to run the option. Then he gets the pitch and goes around the edge. Being close to the goal line. Again, stops you on the goal line.
First out of bounds by number 56. Alex Rido. Hooked up at number 29. Brandon Ritchie. Plays good enough for Bubba Park.
Starting from deep in their own territory. It's just a bad combination.
Laundry on the field.
Gosnak jumped.
False start.
Motion on the Big Macs.
Looks like Gosnak can draw
there. That is one thing Bethel players are trying to do is if the offensive line jumps, it was run across. Run across the line. Watch coming out in the cover three front. Drops back. Hits the bubble and legs taken out by Zach Rush. Took a loss of a couple on the throw.
That's a number 38, Hayden Sell. Back up at number 7, Zach Rush.
That is Dan Max. 7 completed pass this season.
We bring up a second down and 18 yards for the Big Macs.
Five passes thrown by Cannon Mack have been intercepted. 3 of them returned to the house for a score.
Yes, Mike ahead.
drop 86 at the most. Lewis did that. First drive. First drive. Skin drops back to throw it. Literally, nobody was on him. Off his hands. Second dip will do that. Just throwing that out.
Just throwing this out here, it seems like that's the second dip to do that one.
I can't help the things that he like.
Mike, I'm surprised you're able to come up with that.
Number 82, Thomas Kurtz.
What is your game on the play by McDaniel?
Tag by number 17, Dylan Dyskowski. Patriot number, Bethel Park. First down. In the white match territory at their 46-yard line. Game zoomed up for Bethel Park, first down at the 32-yard line of the Big Macs. 14-yard pass play.
This formation, Rush and Emma lined up to the east side. Emma comes in motion to the near side. Goes back to pass, fires a pass to Ernst.
The Beanie's pass is incomplete.
Fires it over the shoulder just a little bit. Had he put a touch of air on that ball, Ernst would have been able to run under it, and
he
had
to defend
it from the field. He would have been easily
into the
touchdown.
It's not a bad throw by Beanie. Still putting on a good performance here. It's good to see.
And then the one interception wasn't all his fault. He's a quarterback. He's been making some pretty good decisions on the game. Enoch. Stop.
Enoch on the carry. Tackled by number 59, Torrey Carr.
Back hits Mitt on a bubble screen.
Stop. Number 32, Alex Mitten. Tackle by number 25, Justin McCullough.
Sam, what are you doing in this situation?
No gain.
I mean, out of people
who are in the
standing, you got 4th and 10, and you're inside the 35. I mean, at this point, I'd go for it.
I do the same thing.
And that, it looks like that's what they're going to do. They have Nathaney checking in and Mascaro checking in. Now the question is, do you put it in the air or do you keep it on the ground?
I say put it in the air. He's proven himself to be a good passer, and especially when you need 10 yards.
Nathaney in the shotgun along with Mitt and Mascaro off the side of him. And he will roll out. Rolls back the other way. He's got Mitt lead blocking for him. It'll be close, and he is able to skip it.
He's going to put the downs on it.
11 yards gained, first down
for Bethel Park. First down.
He's vision off the field. He goes to his right, realizes nobody's there. No one is covering the left side. He turns around, rolls, and rolls back to the side, and hits the first down line. Heads up play by Mitten to realize that he was going to run it. Turns around and seals the edge. He gets a lead block for him, gets the first down. Nice overall play by the Hawks. Danny Amos split far out to the right. Mascaro offset. The give is to Mitten. Zone play. And he stops. He just keeps running.
Alex Mitten on the carry.
That'll be across the line. Or
number 17, Dylan Dyskowski.
Alex Mitten has been playing extremely well.
He's funny because Mitt needs
11-yard gain. 11-yard gain is good enough for Temple Park. First down.
Yeah, wait a minute. My knee never hit the ground. I'm still running. So turn
first and goal to 9 for the Hawks.
Another heads up play. Watch the film. It's okay. And the toss goes out to Mitten. And he...
Mitten on the carry.
Maybe.
Tripped up another 25, adjusting the pull.
And another part of
the game. Tripped up another 56, Alex Rydell.
This team will now have 1 remaining. Here,
16
left here.
Game of 2. Time out for the Hawks.
Even more points for this half zone. I think it will be back
right here. Hey, Hawk fans, I'd like to thank their sponsors for tonight, starting with Kimberly-Clark Consumer Products, the most trusted and recognized consumer brands. For all your chiropractic needs, call Bethel Park Chiropractic Clinic. Dr. Marcinic and his staff have been providing chiropractic care to Bethel Park athletes and their families for over 25 years. Call Bethel Park Chiropractic Clinic for a free exam to see if Dr. Marcinic can help you. 412-835-0636. Here come the Hawks, second down and goal at the 7-yard line.
And Nathaniel back in the gun, runs the option, tries to take it himself, and he will!
That'll bring on Danny Christensen to keep the extra point. Rush to hold. Christensen to kick off for the Blackhawks.
Back again to kick off with 2:09 left in this second quarter. Another good kick by Christensen.
Fielded at the 4.
Frazier on the return for the Big Macs.
Fails. Can't get it across the 20.
Tackle number 24, Danny Emma.
Plays here. Frankly, just try to...
Ball's fine at the 15-yard line of Big Macs. First down 10.
Sell
on the carry.
And the clock critical stop.
Time to bring up 37, Corey Roach.
Injury timeout.
Official timeout for an injury.
It looks like number 88, Jared Hilatus, the sophomore tight end, favoring his right leg.
Sam, I'm going to have to ask you a question. What has impressed you most about this part of the game so far?
So far is just execution. Something we didn't see last week. Something that was very spotty against Mount Lebanon. You know, I've been waiting a couple weeks here to see the execution would play out. And so far, I mean, those Buffy fans, at least I'm impressed with the way they've executed the plays they've worked on this week. The fun information that was Hayden Sell, the sophomore running back. He is stuck in the backfield.
Shadows on the carry.
Number 68, Evan Yarger.
Back to number 68, Evan Yarger.
Bat out of hell.
Ladies and gentlemen, stick around for your halftime show. Starting with the Big Macs and Canada Miller.
Left in the second half here.
And it appears as though Cam Mack is going to try to get another playoff. And Bethel Park going into the half time with a big
lead.
Lots of confidence. And also,
Bethel Park going into the third half.